Staying up all night. I could use my rewind to catch a few more Z's, but maybe I better save my strength. Superhero is dirty work. I need a shower. Whoa! Hello, zombie face. This is what happens when you research quantum physics all night. Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life again. Like, note the Max Caulfield photo memorial wall. This totally reminds me of being a kid in my room. Sorry, Mom. I can make my bed whenever I want. Booyah. I am so not a rebel. I always like my bed to be neat and tidy. Thanks, Mom. Get some peeps together and play a real game instead of drama games. Cartier-Bresson, Doisneau, Hamilton, the greatest. That's the only tourist picture I let them take. That was a good hockey game and a great fight. Man, Kristen and Fernando were so drunk hanging on the Fremont Troll. I could rewind for days and read all of these books. Will I really find any insight into my power? I can't keep my eyes open, but I know there's a scientific answer. This picture will capture this crazy historic moment in my life. Whew, I could get lost doing time travel research. Me and the search engine have become one. If only I could be this focused on homework. Warren is blowing up my inbox now. As long as he helps me figure this out. This is so insane, it sounds logical to me. This wormhole thing makes total sense, but doesn't explain how I can do what no scientist ever has. I would say this is some crazy shit, but now I'm not so certain. Should I sign? And I thought I was into Halloween. Dana is not messing around here. morning, Lisa. Your leaves are lovely today. I may not have a green thumb, but I have a green finger. This picture will capture this crazy historic moment in my life. No smiling. Take your power seriously. This picture will capture this crazy historic moment in my life. Now I have to wonder if any of these films are based on a true story. I'll miss going to the games with my dad. Go Thunderbirds. Would Man Ray call them selfie portraits? Just because some ass pranked a girl's shampoo bottle and her hair fell out, we have to safeguard our toiletries. So, summer camp. Okay, Max, let's hit the showers now. Uh-oh, I wonder if I'll ever wear a watch again. Mrs. Hoyda is still out sick. I heard somebody say she has severe depression. Poor thing.
Do not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like now. Thanks, Sherry.
Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I am so on it, consider it done.
Rachel looks like she's staring at me. No Brooke here. Fine, I won't disturb you. This is like the public DNA of our dorm. Kate is an early bird. She might be up and gone. Alyssa, can you stand over there?
Okay, Max, if that makes you happy. Wow, now that was close. Thank you, Max.
Why, hello again, Alyssa.
Okay, Max. That's twice you've saved me from a projectile weapon. Are you my guardian angel?
Hardly. I just have a sixth sense for trouble. I'm glad to help you out.
Blackwell has a surplus of assholes. Oh, by the way, Warren said you borrowed his epic film flash drive. I didn't know you were a sci-fi geek like us. What's your favorite?
I love Back to the Future, of course, but who doesn't?
Can you imagine going back in time to Blackwell in the 1980s?
We'd suffocate from all the hairspray.
You and Warren do know your sci-fi. Be careful. You might make Brooke jealous.
I'll just pretend I have no idea what you mean. Chloe is so determined to find you, Rachel.
I didn't think Kate was like this. Macking on those bros.
I've never seen Dana this bouncy and happy without a pot of coffee. Hi, Dana. How are you?
Much better than yesterday. I'm glad we talked.
Me too. I know it's good to just talk about this stuff.
You're almost psychic. I felt like you knew everything anyway. By the way, the best and biggest news of the day is that Trevor asked me to the Halloween shindig.
That's awesome, Dana.
At least we're showing our faces together in public. So you absolutely should go with us. Borrow one of my outfits and come as a cute geek couple with your bitch Warren.
I'm not big on cosplay.
Don't let life pass you by, Max. So, are you coming to the party or not?
Why the fuck not? If I hate it, I can always go back to my room.
That's the spirit, Max. After this, you'll be ready for a rave.
It does sound like fun. Now I have to go contemplate my party future. Speaking of Halloween, look at all this makeup. At least Dana knows how to use it. Curiosity killed the Max. Who will survive and what will be left of them? Don't say that out loud, dork. That would be fun to put skulls and ghosts all over Blackwell. Like I could pull this look off? Hello, Victoria. Rollerblades! Oh, I wanted to be a derby girl, but I almost broke my feet just putting them on. That is so damn cute how much Dana is into this Halloween party. This is both sad and pathetic. Trevor is making himself comfortable. Ugh, hope they don't get busted. Wake up, Max. Juliet is next to me in the hall, not her room. Whatever they're watching must be hot stuff.
Hello, Juliet.
Hey, Max. Did you check out Kate's hot video yet?
Why should I?
Because it's fucking hilarious. Church girl gone wild.
Kate's not like that, and you know it.
Really? Check her out and tell me what she's like.
Do you believe everything you see? Like Zachary sexting Dana?
Touché. Now I feel like an ass. Thanks for finding out the truth yesterday.
Are you sure? I thought you'd be pissed.
Not at you. Part of me was almost disappointed because I built up so much rage.
Glad to see you're back in action.
You have a good heart, Max. And I won't watch Kate's video anymore. Or pass it on.
That's the spirit. Thanks, Juliet.
Sure. Talk to you later.
There's Brooke, looking smarter than everybody. Hey, Brooke.
Oh, hi, Max.
You look distracted. Everything cool?
I was riveted by that weird snow flurry yesterday.
I can't tell if you're being serious or not. Since I'm a science noob, I was wondering if you could explain it.
I'm serious. Even meteorologists can't explain that snow. I bet Warren can. Did you talk to him yet?
I will later.
Lucky you. I'm sure he'll track you down, Max. I'll see you around.
Taylor is no doubt being led around by Victoria, as usual. Go Miss Grant. Not sure if I will, though. I'm a loser. Blackwell isn't that big, but it sure feels like a labyrinth. Welcome to Black Hill.
Go away! People sleeping!
Clearly not a morning person. I'd love to make a photo collage of every person who've posted these. Man, people here are merciless. Could be fun. Glad I'm not the only lonely nerd around here. Thanks for the warning. Kate is not good. I wish David would get off her crack, as Chloe would say. Hey, Kate. How are you doing?
I'm here. Thanks again for standing up for me yesterday. I needed that.
Anytime. That guy has issues.
Doesn't everybody here? By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country?
Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later. I'm good to flow. Thanks. Otter power? I'm so not there.
What's up, Kate?
School.
That's it? That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Oh my god, right. Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up, and you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
Yuck, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
We ran all the way-
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate, or Max.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You are such an evil biatch. I love it.
I better get dressed, then go give back Kate's book. Water is almost as good as a cup of strong tea when I'm in sleepy mode.
Hello? Water?
Sorry, I forgot. Is that the link to Kate's video? Damn, Victoria is so fucking mean. Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it. No fucking way. This is not why I came to Blackwell. And I still have to clean all this crap up after I find Kate's book. Man, this could almost be art if it wasn't so fucking sick and disturbed. Oh shit, Nathan's revenge. Even Chloe told me not to go to the principal. My desk is a pigsty, but I know it ain't there. And nothing here. Of course she just spilled soda on Kate's book. Better fix this fast. Kate needs the book and I don't want to add to her list of problems. Be gone, foul soft drink. Aha, you sneaky book. You're mine. Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans. Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week, and he couldn't even rewind time. Now I can finally take this back to Kate before I'm late. As if I have to worry about being late anymore. I do have all the time in the world now. Now I'm getting anonymous threats? It never ends. This has to be from Nathan. But it could be anybody. I better be doubly careful around here, or I could be in serious danger. If I'm not already.
Kate? You in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Max.
Why did she cover up the mirror? She can't look at herself? Kate's art is perfect for a children's book. Everything looks so fun and colorful and positive. Kate really has a doting father. Thank you. I had no idea that Kate ever hung out with Alyssa and Stella. That's a lot of tears. She's going to go through boxes. That is the cutest bunny ever. I bet Kate is a good mommy. Hey, I'm trying to use my powers for good. Ouch. She left out Damnation. Kate is all alone dealing with this video bullshit. I hope her mother doesn't disown her. Kate used to play the violin every morning. She stopped last week. Maybe Kate has a split personality. Church girl by day, party monster by night. Kate even makes notes in her Bible. My parents never once took me to church. I had nothing to rebel against. I don't know what to believe now. Damn, it's the all-American zombie family. Kate's room is usually immaculate. For her, this must be a pigsty. It's way too emo in here. Kate isn't that gloomy. Until lately. Almost forgot what Kate looks like when she smiles. Poor Kate. She doesn't look good.
Hey, Kate, I brought your book.
Max, why did you step in between David and me yesterday?
I hate bullies. David Madsen should know better.
I was hoping he would. But it's nice to see that you care about me.
Kate, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
What about this video? And I swear I haven't watched it.
I can't even watch it, Max.
I won't either.
Thank you, Max. You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
It doesn't sound like you. I can't see you partying with Victoria.
I didn't.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Not enough to get wasted, is it?
I don't get wasted. Ever. I take a sip at church and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Nathan Prescott? Oh, shit.
He was being nice for a change when he offered to help me.
He's the opposite of nice. What next?
All I recall is driving for a long time. Then I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on. I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck. And? That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here near my bag. So, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
Yes, you should definitely go to the police, Kate. I totally believe every word you say. Nathan Prescott is truly dangerous.
Bless you, Max. I will go to the police, and also Principal Wells. With you as my backup witness, they'll have to take us seriously now.
Backup witness? Well, I mean, I believe you in everything, but we're still just spoiled punk students to the cops and faculty. I just think we need to be very careful here.
Why? Careful of what?
Nothing. Except the Prescotts are a powerful family. I hope this won't backfire on us, that's all. Even though that rich bastard has earned some serious bad karma. He'll get it. Time out, Max. You actually told Kate to go to the police and the principal after getting a scary text threat. Now the police will definitely drag you into this shit.
Excuse me, I'm texting Zach.
Paint job looks great. Samuel knows his color schemes. I've never seen Samuel wearing shades. And what's with this other crap? see that Samuel's concerned, but does he need a poster? How did Samuel get photos of Rachel posing? I definitely won't play with this thing again. Samuel really should keep this locked. It's a waiting accident and too easy to sneak into. How hard is it to dump the trash into a bin? But I could use this to attract squirrels. Can't Blackwell have at least one no football zone? Warren told me that totem is named Tobanga for a reason nobody knows. The birds are flocking around Samuel. Ah, there's Samuel, up early, already communing with the critters. Hey, Samuel. You're up early.
Oh, hello, young Max. I do love the early morning. Everything is so calm and quiet. And I can feel the animals waking up with me.
That's one thing I truly love about Arcadia Bay. It's all those cool animals in the forest.
The squirrels always come in the morning for food. I can hear them whisper. What animals do you see in the forest?
Don't laugh, but I saw a doe that seemed to be looking right at me, like it was trying to communicate.
Oh, that's your spirit animal. Nothing weird there except you saw yours. Could be a sign about your destiny. What do I know? My spirit animal is a squirrel.
So, what did you think about that freak snow shower yesterday?
Another message from the Earth to get our shit together. I will say that Samuel hasn't seen anything like that before.
Sorry to pry, Samuel, but why are there photos of Rachel Amber in your shed? I'm curious about her.
Sorry to pry, she says while prying. Now everybody wants to know about her.
So did you know her?
Like I told the police. She was a good egg. And she gave me those photos.
Oh, you talked to the police? Rachel wanted to be a model.
Yeah. She gave out headshots like squirrels chasing food. Keep on prying, Max. Sounds like you have a lot of time on your hands.
I so don't want to get in the way of your morning ritual. See you later.
Of course you will.
I don't think I've actually seen Taylor alone without Team Victoria. Hi, Taylor.
Hi, Taylor. Just because you were nice to Victoria doesn't mean I have to be nice to you.
I don't want to fight with you or Victoria. Instead of smack talk, let's just talk, for once.
You're funny. Well, I'm not doing anything at the moment, so talk.
Kate is really upset about the video. All this gossip is cruel.
Boo-hoo. That's what happens when you preach to everybody about sex. She'll live.
Why do you hang out with Victoria? She's pretty mean to you and Courtney.
And she's bossy, too. Look, you don't know her. I do. And she's one of the best friends you could have.
I guess I've had mean, bossy best friends, too. Better than having mean, bossy parents.
I would love it if my mom was mean or bossy instead of sick. But whatever. We've had our talk.
Hi, Taylor.
Hi, Taylor. Just because you were nice to Victoria doesn't mean I have to be nice to you.
I've heard that your mother was sick. I'm so sorry. What happened to her?
Well, if you do care, my mom had back surgery. Victoria was there for me. Like you are for Kate. I'm not about tearing people down, Max.
I know. That's why I wanted to talk.
I'm glad we did.
Max, come on over here.
Warren is out and about already, too. Looks like he's waiting for somebody. Warren, what are you doing here?
Well, nothing. Waiting for a call? I mean, I already took the call. Anyway, I wanted to rap about that action yesterday.
That was intense. Everything happened so fast. I owe you.
Oh, yes, you do. I got knocked on my ass by that dick. I'm some personal superhero.
You're a real everyday hero. You stood up to a bully, and it was awesome.
Even though you left me with said bully and ran off with that girl, she's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
An old friend, Chloe Price. We haven't seen each other in a while.
I bet you were glad to see her blast up in that truck like a rock star. Which begs the question, why is Nathan Prescott getting psycho on you?
I busted him in the bathroom yesterday with a gun. I'll give you the story later. Principal Wells is taking care of it now, I hope.
Weird fucking week. Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia, that drive-in is having a 70s Planet of the Apes marathon. Let's go ape!
Yes, that's exactly what I need. I love those old school ape films.
Well, that was easier than I thought. Cool, I'll text you the info.
David talking to Nathan cannot be a good thing. This has something to do with Kate. Or Rachel.
some light and it'll be alright for now. Crosses alone, heavy on your shoulders. The sirens inside you. Some light and you'll be alright. Catch some light and you'll be alright for now. Crosses all over the boulevard.
Yep, I'm ready to cash my luck.
Crosses.
Glad somebody is.
Don't try to take it from me. It's mine.
I wouldn't dream of it.
I'm gonna be a millionaire. Hope nobody steals my lottery.
Talk about going back in time. The diner looks exactly the same. I bet he's seen a lot of changes to Arcadia Bay in his lifetime.
No time for chit-chat. I'm a millionaire. Yep. Got my lottery ticket right here. Waiting for the bus so I can cash it in.
She looks busy and stressed. Hi. You look lost.
Close. Do you know if the bus has come yet? The online schedule isn't working.
I just got off the school bus, but I'm sure the regular bus is coming too.
Oh, that's a relief. I can't be late for this job interview. I can't believe I have to take a bus all the way to Newport just to find a second job.
Are things that bad here?
Where are things good? I can't even afford to live here.
Well, good luck.
Thanks, I sure need it.
There's that dirty RV from the other day. Obviously, nobody took my advice.
Stop that! Stop! No barking.
There was something creepy about that guy and his dog. Look at all these flyers. It's so sad that nobody will read them. He looks like a photo of the classic Arcadia Bay crusty fisherman.
Good morning. Looks like you're ready to catch some serious fish.
I wish, young gal. Arcadia Bay just isn't the same fishing town I grew up in.
Has the town changed much?
By Neptune's beard, it has. Seems like a lifetime ago when I was king of the harbor.
You have your own boat?
I call her the Bali High. I've kept a hold of her in these lean days. Might be all the time we've got left.
I thought one of Arcadia Bay's main exports was fish.
Oh, the fish used to jump onto my boat until the Prescotts and their finance fiends snapped up harbor rights.
The Prescotts have a lot of power.
They might rename the town Prescott Bay, if that tells you much.
They own my school.
Crooks gain respect when they put their names on schools and libraries. Let's not get downcast. I hear the fish calling for Bali High. Never forget that old fishermen never die. We just smell that way.
I'd love to learn more, but I have to get going. Happy fishing out there. That sign reminds me of so many times I ate here with Chloe and my family. When we were happy. I wonder if they explained that snow. Snow? Well, that's a good start to the story. Newspapers are going to be retro soon. Excuse me, sir?
Can you believe this town? The world is on fire, and our big headline is snow. I can hardly wait for next week's big story. Clouds!
The snow was pretty odd. It was right in the middle of a warm, sunny day.
Ugh, global warming bullshit. It's the Northwest. Snow happens.
I keep reading how Arcadia Bay is booming.
The paper can only talk about that or about missing girls.
You mean Rachel Amber?
I guess. I bet she ran away because she was bored. Who wouldn't be here?
Poor woman. I hope it's a shelter for her. Hello.
Aw, look at you. A fine example of youth. I bet you're a senior student.
Yes, I go to Blackwell Academy.
I could tell you're a wise young woman. I know all about Blackwell and this town.
You must know Joyce Price from the Two Whales Diner.
She's fed me more than my own family. How's a daughter your age who's always in trouble? Married to a real prick.
His name is David Madsen.
He told me to get a job once, asshole. Not sure what Joyce sees in him, but he better treat her right.
I bet you have dirt on the Prescott family.
That whole family is dirty. They once done good things for Arcadia Bay. Those days are dead, like anything in their way.
I know somebody who's being threatened by a Prescott.
Then you be their guardian angel, because nothing gets in the way of that family, especially not the law. Hell, they own your school, Blackwell. Almost.
How long have you lived in Arcadia Bay?
1,000 years. I've gone through the same changes as the town.
What changes to the town?
Ones it takes a lifetime to see. There's a lot of beauty here, but a lot of darkness, too. Greedy bastards that ruin this town put people out of work. Out of home. Like me.
I'm sorry. Have you ever lived outside of here?
Where the hell would I go? I hate the sun and love the mist. I might be homeless. But Arcadia Bay is still my home.
I have to go now. Goodbye. smell of breakfast and the sound of clanging silverware makes me feel 13 again. Now that brings back memories. Chloe and I loved the parade. These fishermen are so damn quiet.
Did you catch any big ones today?
If by big you mean none, then sure. I caught a lot of big ones today. Now let me mourn over my eggs.
I always wonder what people think about when they eat alone.
Hello there to you! Such a beautiful day, eh? Oh yeah, it's gonna be a super day. Enjoy your breakfast, eh?
Oh man, I bet that's the same gum from when I was here last. This guy has serious cojones. Why does that so not sound fun? I might make Chloe check this out with me. The poster doesn't mention whacked students with guns. I would buy a shirt, but they're so damn tourist. You'd never know how weird this town is by these postcards. That graffiti has been here forever. Thank you, redneck poet. Gross. Ew, that guy looks unpleasant.
What do you want? I feel like shit. Too much beer, so spare me, please. Just let me suffer quietly.
That officer looks nicer than wannabe cop David Madsen.
Hello, sir.
Hi, young lady. You look a little lost.
Just hungry and thinking about what to eat.
Now, that is a real problem at the Two Wells. I can never decide. Joyce's pumpkin pie or grilled mac and cheese.
How well do you know Joyce?
I know her delicious grub. Everybody at the station comes here. We take care of this place like it's our own kitchen. And Joyce, like she's our mother.
So you know Chloe?
Sadly, we all know Chloe down at the station. Poor Joyce. Just heard that Chloe even had a pot dealer in her room.
Who told you that?
I didn't hear it on the police scanner. Joyce said the weed belonged to Chloe's friend, but I highly doubt that.
Joyce didn't tell you who?
She wouldn't. Afraid I'd go arrest somebody, as if I would. I'd just tell that loser to stay the hell away from Chloe, or else. I'm just kidding. Besides, David Madsen's watching over. Is she a friend of yours?
I know her.
Then you know she's a handful.
She can be, but she can also be a good friend who shows up when you need her.
Sounds like you're a good friend. I wish she would be a great daughter and not cause Joyce so much stress.
I guess you're friends with David Madsen.
I wouldn't use that word. We know each other. Why do you ask?
Just curious. I'm surprised he's not a police officer in Arcadia Bay.
I have respect for David. He served his country. He found his calling at Blackwell. At the station, we're happy David is exactly where he is. Not everybody can be a cop.
I have to go now. Enjoy your breakfast.
By the way, one thing I can tell you for certain is to stay away from that RV outside.
I usually stay away from sketchy parked vehicles.
Wise policy. The guy who lives in it, Frank, is pretty sketchy himself. That's all I can say for now. I should finish up my coffee and get to work.
I wouldn't last one day as a trucker. Those rigs are...
I don't feel like talking right now. I gotta deliver a load of breakfast to my stomach. Over and out.
Hello?
Pardon moi, but you're in my eyesight.
Isn't everything in here within eyesight?
I don't care for your tone. You sound like Joyce.
How does Joyce sound?
Bossy and smartass. Like you.
Joyce rules. I want to be exactly like her when I grow up.
Looks like you're on your way. I've been coming to this dive for 3 years, and Joyce gives me shit like it's going out of style.
That's how she rolls. That's why I worship her every move.
Good. I can't wait to see you flipping greasy bacon in a diner when you grow up. Exactly like Joyce. Now pardon me while I get back to my coffee.
Drool. Want everything. Forgot about the Fishing Wall of Fame. Whoa, Ken Kesey with Joyce? That's so perfect. I got you, babe. How apropos. But no fucking way. That's funny. Our family never went whale watching. Looks fun. Justin is such a mellow dude. What's up, Justin?
Getting my coffee on before I cut class and destroy some rails. Shouldn't you be taking photos?
I am always taking photos. I am a camera.
You cracked me up, Maxer. Of course I'm baked. So I'll laugh at anything.
You should be studying, bad boy.
So where's all your homework, schoolgirl?
School? Speaking of buds, I saw your bro Trevor sneaking out of Dana's room.
Trevor finally told me about him and Dana hooking up. He got there first, so I snooze and I lose. See you later, Max.
Hey, Trevor.
Holla, Max. By the way, I know you saw me in the dorm.
Yeah, I saw you coming out of Dana's room.
Yeah, and I finally had to tell Justin because, well, he was into her too.
How did Justin react?
I got him blazed. He was cool. Nobody has secrets in Blackwell anyway. See you in class, Max.
There she is. A lovely young woman. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. It's nice to see you again. You look the same.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
No, like you still look pretty.
Nice save, kid. You're still smart. But not that smart. Now you get busted for smoking pot. I heard the whole sordid story from David. I'm sorry this was how you had to meet him. He's a good man, no matter what Chloe says.
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't even smoke, like, ever. It was almost an accident. It was very stupid. I'm sorry.
It surprised me fierce. I was hoping you could be a good influence in her life now.
I will be. Promise. I know things were hard for you and Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call. Now my folks are in Seattle, and I'm all alone at Blackwell. It's my karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did after William passed on. Chloe chose to stay angry. Anyway, I hope we see more of you. Chloe needs an old friend again.
Joyce, I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
I'm glad, Max. That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories. Even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
Chloe must have changed a lot during that time.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings, blue hair. Now she's got to rebel against her stepfather.
I see why, I mean.
Do you? He's not as much of a hard ass as you think. But you did tell him you had a joint, right? You took that responsibility?
I did. And I am sorry. I don't want Chloe in any more trouble. Or me.
Nobody's in trouble over a doobie, Max. And I admire that you took the heat for Chloe. Like a great friend. But Chloe does push David, and it's not fair. He paid his dues in a war. He does care about her, along with all the students at Blackwell.
He cares about Kate Marsh?
David mentioned her, but I stay out of his business. I won't patrol Blackwell, and he won't cook at the diner, you know?
I saw him arguing with Kate. I thought you might know why.
Nice try, Nancy Drew. But next to you, there's only one student I'm worried about. And she's not even in school anymore. So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty. What do you want to eat?
I was dreaming about your bacon omelet.
Now finish your coffee. One bacon omelet for the young lady stat.
Nerd graffiti. Warren must have been here. I love the delish anticipation of breakfast. The only thing that's changed on the menu are the prices. The lighthouse looks so mysterious. I wish I could stay in this moment forever. I guess I actually can now. But then it wouldn't be a moment.
No beer?
Looks like you had plenty. Stick.
Oh yes, black coffee. You will be mine. This is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going back in time.
No beer? What kind of dive is this?
I can hear your stomach rumbling from here, Max. Here, you'll love this.
I'm drooling like a baby.
Still can't believe you're a woman. When I look at pictures of Chloe, ugh. Speak of the devil.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe looking for a free meal. You put your whole damn college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
Are you atoning for yesterday?
Oh God, Mom, please do not give Max any shit for that. She apologized.
I know she did. Max is a good girl. Woman. She's 18 now.
Too old to get lectures from you or Sergeant Pepper.
Call him David if you don't want to be lectured. You only get one damn slice of bacon a day.
You guys are still the same.
Another reason to blow this town. What is this shit on the jukebox? Now that that's out of the way, let's talk about your superpower.
I don't have any explanation. And I can't explain why I saw that crazy fucking tornado.
Come on, that's just a daydream. I want proof you can rewind time.
This is all happening so fast.
We'll start slow. Right here, now.
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have X-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets. Let me see.
Okay, Max. Impress me.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A bullet, just like your necklace.
That was so wrong, Max. Okay, psychic girl, let me show you what's actually in my pockets. That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
Okay, Max, study every item carefully and don't forget anything. You got this, Max. Now rewind and blow Chloe's mind. So, this is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
A parking ticket.
You know me well. But what is the exact time I was busted?
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time! Even a broken clock is right twice a day. Whatever the hell that means.
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
7 cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
86 cents.
That's right. Living large in Arcadia Bay. Amazeballs. I literally just got chills all over my neck. You have powers.
I'll take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
How's the food, Max?
Better than I remembered.
Very good save.
Man, I'm hungry like the wolf.
Clearly.
I'm freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more, something way cooler, so I will believe you without any doubt.
I will predict the future.
No way!
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments, so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Oops!
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh! Well, now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick!
Don't slap me, bitch! Take your fight club outside!
He started it!
I'm finishing it!
That's the best song I've heard.
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
I'm going to predict 4 events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so. The trucker drops his mug and Joyce rips him a new one.
So, what happens next?
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and his partner in the car leaves without him.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
Oops.
Did you break another cup?
Oh, way
really?
To go, Mom.
No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You called it. But he's off to go bust some skaters.
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Trevor and Justin must be in love. You predicted a cockroach on the jukebox? I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands.
This isn't a toy, Chloe. I do have to be careful how I use it.
Screw that! Of course it's a toy. The best toy ever? You can bang anyone with no strings attached, rewind time, and boom! It's like it never happened.
Grow up.
Maybe you made a move on me and I would never know.
Yes, that's what I did.
You can rewind time, Max. That's fucking insane. We have to play.
I don't have time.
You did not just say that. Check out your nose. Too much blow? Hey, are you okay?
Too much excitement. See what happens when we hook up again?
Then, let's go to one of my secret lairs and fully test your power. You need a sidekick to guide you.
Okay, Girl Wonder. Show me the way to Chloe's cave.
Okay, Supergirl, let's go to my secret place. Don't even answer. We have places to go and people to do. Come on, before Mom starts some more shit, let's bail.
It's Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Big whoop. You don't call me once in 5 years and now you're all over some biatch you see every day at school? I see how you roll. So go ahead, chat up Kate Marsh from Blackwell. I've got other people to hang out with too. Later, Mom.
Bye, Joyce.
Freedom!
I feel bad about Kate.
She'll survive you not taking that one call. Now follow me, young Squire Max, so we can seriously tap your power and rule the world.
I hope Kate doesn't get upset that I didn't answer.
Wait up, Speedy.
Dude, this is gonna be so cool.
Slow down. Wait for me to get your present.
You can just back time up. We'll have to test you now to make sure. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back, and she's also supersized.
We don't know for how long.
Exactly why it's time to have fun.
Are you kidding? After yesterday, I'm kind of over guns, Chloe. Freaks me out that you have one.
Don't you trust me?
Yes, but not that gun.
You have more power than an army. Don't be scared of my little toy. Besides, we need it for the test. Drink?
Yuck.
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit. Okay, let's do this. Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles, pretty please. Thank you.
hard to believe that was once on the road, filled with dozens of students. Look what we have here. A cute little bottle for the taking.
Break time.
Stupid bottle. Hello, bottle number one. Four more to go. So sad to look at a grounded boat. I wonder who owned that and where they are now. Beyond repair. Rest in peace. I wonder how many generations of fashion went through that washing machine. Wowzer. That looks exactly like the same dough from my tornado vision. Dough is the perfect photo op. This was an old school punk shirt. I wonder if Chloe thinks about her father when she looks at all these smashed up cars. Boom, only 3 bottles left. I'm sure this is a popular party pit. Oh yes, we can use this one for a target. 3 down, 2 more to go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack. Thanks for the tip. This looks like a graffiti museum for Chloe and Rachel. I bet I can find out more about Rachel here. That kind of hurts. I can't see Chloe playing with makeup. Now, what's up with this weird secret relationship? Sounds like Rachel was confused about it, maybe even ashamed. I wish she named names. I better not show this to Chloe, or she will be seriously hurt. They really were besties. That could have been me instead of Rachel. Rachel songs. I wonder if Chloe would ever make me a mixtape. Ouch. Oh, there you are, little bottle. Trying to play hide and seek. One more bottle to go. I want to die. Jeez. Who wrote this? So Rachel did go to a Vortex Club party. This flyer is dated right before she disappeared. I don't want to intrude, but I was here. Now we're officially a trio. We just have to find Rachel. They would have gone all the way to Los Angeles for a rave. Looks fun. Voila! Now I can deliver this bottle booty to Captain Chloe. Aw, poor thing. They left you here all alone. I could use this board as a bridge. Doesn't look too heavy. All this rusted metal makes me feel serene. Am I morbid or just goth? Those shells look fresh. The Bigfoots were here. I could use this board as a bridge. Doesn't look too heavy. Way heavier than I thought. Ugh. Although this junkyard is a dive, I see why Chloe hangs here. She's a steampunk. It actually feels like Chloe and I are kids again. We're hiding out and plotting our future. Despite all the chaos and bullshit, I feel so giddy hanging out with her again. So happy. Like we've both gone back in time. That's my Chloe.
Thanks, Max. Wait, one more for the road.
You're serious about this.
We're gonna shoot all these bottles without wasting a single bullet. Max? You have to help me aim. Show me the way, Max.
I need to see you shoot first. Show me. Aim a bit to the right.
Sir, yes, sir. Oh, yes! Did you see that shit, Max?
Duh.
That was so fucking cool! Now for the second bottle.
Now, Max, where do I aim? You're on target. Pull the trigger. Now, Max, where do I aim? Slightly above.
Right between the eyes. Watch out, Nathan. Now that is fun. Let's pump up the volume and find me another target. I want to get creative here. Give me something to shoot, Max. Hello, what should I shoot?
Let's take out this wheel rim on your left.
Taking out the wheel rim now? Hella yes!
Nice shooting, Tex.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Satisfied?
Like never? So I want one more uber cool trick shot.
How about using that junker for a target now?
Dude, I need a target before I shoot.
I want to see that windshield go down.
Watch out for flying glass! You guys better run for cover! Yet the bottle remains. Dude, I need a target before I shoot.
How about aiming for the left tire?
Adios, spinning wheel of death. Uber cool. I cannot believe this is for reals. My best friend is a superhero! Now it's your turn to bust a cap.
I don't know.
Max, your nose. Damn.
I don't feel so super.
Max! You freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now?
A little. Thanks for helping me. Just give me a minute.
Too much action for Arcadia?
Maybe not enough. This is kind of fun. Scary and stupid, but fun.
Let me know when you feel okay.
God, this power really messes with my head. I'm glad I feel normal again. I better go chat up Chloe.
Okay, looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble?
Oh, boo-hoo, Max is afraid.
I know you can handle this, and I'm here to guide you. Make me proud, sister.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise. Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
We're not anything alike, man.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a shitload, don't you, Chloe? Huh?
You'll get your money.
Don't they all say that? You know, even when they're broke and acting tough? What are you hiding there, girlie? Let me see.
Where did you get that bracelet?
A friend, and it's none of your goddamn business. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't. You stole that shit. Give it to me right now, asshole.
You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please. Please step back.
You're kidding. Put that down. That is hilarious. Oh, man. I'll remember you, kid. I'll remember you almost shot me. And you'll wish I had no memory, because I never forget. You have until Friday to pay me. Don't ever pull crap like this again. It'll be the last time you do. Try bullets next time, brainiacs.
Sorry.
You are awesome. Thanks for standing up for me. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Jesus, I almost shot this guy. And now he'll be more dangerous to Chloe and me. Wowzer. Why did Frank have Rachel's bracelet? We need to talk about this later, but I better follow Chloe now. Chloe's waiting to go for a walk. We both need a timeout from here.
I still can't believe you pulled a gun on Frank. That was epic.
It felt awful. I'm glad there was no bullets in there.
You can just rewind time in your hand and stick that barrel right up Frank's ass. You have the power!
You're gross. Don't fall.
I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around scary losers like Frank? It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk. Feels like a different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
Can we build another pirate fort and keep the world out?
We need a new secret hangout. At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
Seriously, Chloe, this is scary. What if Frank tries to track us down?
I'm sorry, but Frank isn't as hardcore as he fronts. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, did you see what just happened? I almost shot him. I know I could rewind, but Chloe, this is not playtime. No more guns.
Max, I know. Crazy shit is the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank. Does he have a last name?
Frank Bowers, he's just a dealer where I get my weed. The one in your joint, remember? Anyway, Frank and I kind of hung out.
Hung out? You don't mean you...
Oh, no, we didn't have sex. Gross, man. He never even tried. I just made the mistake of borrowing money so Rachel and I could bail out of here.
That's it?
No. I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
I think we have to be careful and keep an eye on this guy. Without him eyeballing us, okay?
It's so weird talking to you about this insane crap. We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens, and it's like no time has passed. I wish Rachel was here to meet you.
Do you think that Rachel and I would have been friends?
You're not that different. She has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
You are. You just have to stop being afraid.
Perfect. Budget at all.
Come on, Max. Hurry.
I can definitely use this bad boy.
Please get me out of here.
Okay, what can I slice with this? Now I can pull a total MacGyver. In and out, no problem. Which wire to cut?
Come on, Max! Hurry!
Oh, stupid light! No go! Shit!
Come on, Max!
But which wire to cut?
Hurry!
Now that's the right cable. Yes! I did it! You okay?
You saved me again! Crazy! Now we're totally bonded for life.
Damn. That was close.
Aren't you glad I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Nothing exciting ever happens to us, right?
Listen, your rewind power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
Explain what? Snow equals a ginormous twister that takes out Arcadia Bay? You're high.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
What do you know about chaos theory, Miss I Hate Math?
5 years ago, asswipe. Some people change. And your situation is the perfect storm for quantum physics.
Why me? I'm just a geek girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you kids anything at Blackwell? We have a tornado, rewind power, and freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar!
Like you said, Professor Price, a superhero needs a sidekick.
How can it be such a shitty week, and yet one of the best of my life?
Because we're back in action again. Little time before Mr. Jefferson's class, so I can do some wandering.
So are you going to that Vortex Club party?
How many students ever actually memorize all this shit? I guess we all should these days. Justin always looks stoned. I swear, Principal Wells always looks distressed. Sir?
Oh, hello, Max. I hope this isn't about the alleged gun incident.
Alleged? Nathan did have a gun. Have you talked to him yet?
Yes, he's deeply upset about this accusation. I don't blame him. Once I have all the facts, we'll talk. For the moment, focus on your schoolwork.
I can't focus when I'm scared.
Please don't say that. There's nothing to be scared of at Blackwell Academy. Our head of security is overseeing a new era of campus safety.
I saw Mr. Madsen hassle Kate Marsh yesterday.
Wait. Do you see a pattern here, Max?
Probably not the same one you see.
It's very easy for you to instantly accuse people of doing terrible things. Nathan, Mr. Madsen, who's next? Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a meeting.
Zachary always looks like he's ready to throw a football. Hello, Zach.
Sup, Max? It's weird to not see you without your camera.
I'm always taking pictures with my eyes.
I bet. As long as you don't talk to everybody about all that shit with the sext and Victoria.
I won't. That's what Victoria wanted.
Yeah. I noticed she kind of set up her own drama, even if it fucks her over. Weird.
She doesn't have to, though.
That's what I don't get at all. When she's hot, rich, talented, what more does she need? Anyway, see you at the game Friday, Max.
That snow was so insane. Seriously. Hello, climate change.
If I was normal, I'd be super excited about going to a major shindig. Join us, or die. Courtney will do anything for Victoria and the Vortex Club.
Hey, Courtney.
Ciao, Max. No photos, please. I have to come up with a guest list for a Vortex Club soiree.
Really?
Oh, like you care.
I'm not anti-soiree.
You seem anti-fashion, though. A Vortex Club party has a strict dress code. Do you even have a dress? Sorry, but nice try. Hey, Courtney. Ciao, Max. No photos, please. I have to come up with a guest list for a Vortex Club soiree.
Really?
Oh, like you care.
I'm sure the Vortex Club has a dress code. As you can see, I would need your advice on what to wear.
Thanks, Max. I didn't think you noticed high fashion. Tell you what, I'll put you down on the guest list, and before the party, I can give you some tips.
Cool. Thanks, Courtney.
I'll send you the party info later. Back to the list.
Trevor surveys his domain. If only I knew what David Madsen was really up to.
Excuse me, Mr. Madsen?
I know things got a little heated yesterday in Chloe's room. Was that really your reefer?
Yes, it was. You know that marijuana is almost legal in Oregon. I can get it at Blackwell. Are you gonna bust me now, Mr. Madsen?
Even I'm not that much of an asshole. And I am sorry about yesterday. I was wrong, but upset. Cannabis is not a big deal to you, but it has been to Chloe.
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that. All you kids are. So is Kate Marsh.
What about Kate?
You stepped between us at a pretty bad time. She's another matter entirely.
Kate hasn't done anything wrong.
Max, this isn't just about Kate Marsh. My concern is for the safety of all Blackwell students, including you.
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security? Unless you know something about Rachel Amber that nobody else does.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore. That's all, Max.
I still have time. I could go see Warren playing mad scientist in the lab. Luke is always using the phone as a shield to avoid people.
Tori and her friends shopping for the apartment.
That reminds me, I have to score some weed from Nathan.
I really hope this jackass will use protection next time. Juliet is laying the smackdown on Zachary. Miss Grant is so cool and smart. She defines the word teacher. Hi, Miss Grant.
Funny, I was just thinking about you, Max. Thanks again for taking a stand against camera surveillance here. Every signature counts.
How's your campaign going?
You signed the petition, now it's your campaign too. Thanks for stepping up. More people would rather send a text than sign a petition. That's how they keep us all distracted. Nobody will notice cameras on every square foot.
I know. I really hope you keep those cameras from taking over Blackwell.
Max, with students like you, we sure will.
I'm just thinking about all the autumn photos I want to take.
Oh, this is my favorite time of year. I do love the season change. This whole campus is a visual delight. I know Mr. Jefferson loves to shoot around here.
You must know Mr. Jefferson pretty well by now.
I certainly know him as a talented artist and terrific teacher. I've been here a little longer, but he's made a bigger mark. I have to say, it's not quite autumn enough yet.
What about that snow yesterday? What's your scientific explanation?
Our climate is moving beyond explanation. Of course, some of the tribes here might see it different.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant, but I have to get going.
Go on, Max. We'll talk again. Real soon.
A periodic table. Wish I knew what periodic means. Da Vinci was a boss. I bet if I touch the glass, all these creepy sea creatures will pop up. Or nothing will happen at all.
This can't be that hard.
Brooke always kind of pretends like I'm almost not there. Why? Howdy, Brooke.
Hi, Max. Making your daily rounds?
How is your drone?
Miss Grant busted me flying it over the parking lot. She's all jacked up about surveillance bullshit. Like I was spying on Warren's new car.
You already planted a GPS on him?
I borrowed the one he has on you.
I hate to hit and run, but...
Don't let me get in your way. So long.
Bring me the brain, Igor. There's Mr. Wizard, hard at work. Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful, yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer! Perfect timing! I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
I'm not sure why you're letting me decide your fate, but go potassium.
Potassium it shall be. If this works, you get a free hug. Weird science.
Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer. Perfect timing. I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
I actually think you should use a lot of potassium. I mean, a shitload.
See? Look at that smile. You're going to become a scientist yet. Let's do this thing. She blinded me with science.
Hi again, Miss Grant.
Right back at you, Max.
Miss Grant, can I ask you a possibly dumb science question?
You know my stock teacher answer. There are no dumb questions. Ask away.
Would you add potassium or sodium to a chemical mix for this week's experiment?
Neither, unless you want a face full of powder. I would add chlorine.
I'm sorry, Miss Grant, but I have to get going.
Go on, Max. We'll talk again. Real soon.
Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer. Perfect timing. I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
Wrong, Warren. You need to add chlorine, not potassium or sodium.
Chlorine? I didn't think of that. Can't argue with a confident scientist. Let's try it. Eureka! She's got it.
No, you got it.
Don't be so modest, Dr. Caulfield.
That was fun helping Warren. He's pretty cute when he's in full-on geek mode.
Being on a viral video.
Wonder why they don't use real skeletons. I hate having everybody see inside my locker. I love how Evan is so above the Vortex Club and everything else.
Yo, Maxwell Smart. Talk later, cool?
Nobody believes me, and so you can't help me?
I'm trying, but you have to understand my position.
Why? You don't understand mine. Nobody does.
I bet Mr. Jefferson has had to deal with a lot of troubled students. Sorry to bother you, Mr. Jefferson.
I'm only bothered when you avoid turning in photos. But you know this. So what can I do for you, Max?
Just between you and me, I'm worried about Kate Marsh.
That's no secret. Word on the street is that you and Kate had a little confrontation with our security chief yesterday.
I stepped in between David Madsen barking all up in Kate's face about something. She doesn't deserve that.
Of course not. Mr. Madsen isn't the most gentle soul. Do you have proof he instigated the situation?
My word isn't good enough? The one time I choose not to take a picture.
Always take the shot. My number one rule of photography. And Max, I promise this matter is being discussed by the faculty. I assume you know about this viral video?
Everybody knows. That's why I wanted to see you. Kate is being humiliated daily.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well, but maybe she doth protest too much. She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
Yes, I talked to her this morning. She needs friends and support now. I just don't want Kate Marsh to become the next Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
I miss Rachel too. But think about yourself, Max. Principal Wells told me about what you said happened in the bathroom.
It did happen. Nathan Prescott had a gun in the girls' bathroom yesterday.
This is a serious accusation, Max.
So you don't believe me? I would never make something like this up.
I hope so, Max. But it's easy to point fingers. If Mr. Madsen claims you might be a pot dealer as he did, should I believe him?
Listen, should I...
Excuse me, Max. Hello? Yes? Hold on. I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon.
Yes. Uh-huh. Sure, okay. Listen, I do have a class I have to teach. I have to go.
Stella is smart to stay out of all the drama.
Vogue.
Dana, you are out of control. Turn left, then right. Show me the love.
How do I look, Taylor? Do you look like me?
Not now, Max. I'm contemplating shit.
It's hard to not like Hayden because he just doesn't give a shit.
I'm kind of doing something now, Max.
Dana is ready for her 15 minutes of fame.
No time to talk, Max. Posing in progress.
That's a great sketch of Dana. Daniel is the real deal.
Do you think Max will be pissed we're sitting at her desk?
Oh, I'm sure she'll report us to the principal.
No time to talk,
Max. Art
in progress. Or she'll run to Mr. Jefferson, like he gives a shit.
Like anybody does.
I can't believe the principal lets him stay in school after I told him what happened.
Better be quiet, Victoria. We have a master snitch and liar here.
Did you think we were best friends forever or something?
Not at all, Victoria.
Max is such an attention whore.
You would know. Can I sit down now?
Oh, please do. Take a selfie of this moment.
Yeah, Max, so I won't forget you.
Assholes. Okay, why is David taking photos of Kate? Now this is so wrong and weird.
What up, Max?
Hey, Warren.
I saw Kate earlier and her eyes were puffy from crying.
Kate has a lot on her plate.
I didn't know what to say, and she didn't tell me anything.
Okay, I know you love me, but if you're not in this class, beat it. Everybody else, please sit down.
We
have a lot to cover today, and so little time as usual. I see all the usual suspects here. Anybody seen Kate Marsh?
I think everybody has seen Kate.
I guess Kate will miss class now. She's not. I'm worried about her.
Sounds like you're giggling about a video gone viral.
It's cool that Mr. Jefferson published his own little book of photo tips.
Maybe it involves a student? Or a friend? I wonder how it would feel to have false images of yourself shot out all over the world for people to judge. You... No smartphones in class, Max. Put that away. Usually, people need something to judge so they never take a good look at themselves. We can thank reality TV for some of that. In the end, we can only blame ourselves for participating. Speaking of participation, there are a few souls here who have yet to enter a photo in the contest. Like Max Caulfield, for example, who I know can't wait to enter, right? I'm sure you read the syllabus like it was a Harry Potter book, so you must know today we're studying chiaroscuro. That beautiful word about the contrast between light and dark. The shadow play that gives photography such visual power. It's basic yin and yang. Black and white images are effective precisely because of their contrast. Although we don't technically see in mind.
Yo! Some crazy shit is going down in the girls' dorm!
Zachary, do not come into my class like that ever again. Listen, everybody remain seated. Dismissed.
You see that? Is this for real?
Bitch flipped out!
I didn't think she was that messed up.
Who is that up
there? Kate! No! Oh, God.
She can't die. She can't. Not now.
No!
I have to try something. I won't be able to rewind again and again. Yes.
Oh! What are you doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work. I don't have any power. Now I have to do this by myself?
Max, seriously, don't come near me. I will jump.
Okay, okay. I'm right here. Kate, please.
Oh, Max, I know you want to help me. I love that you stepped up to David, but it doesn't matter now. Nothing matters.
You matter, and not just to me.
I do want to believe that.
Kate, your life is still yours, and we can get through this together. Let me help, like I helped by erasing all that crap people wrote on your room slate.
Thanks for that, but I needed you more when I called to actually talk. That's when I needed a friend.
I swear, it was in silent mode, and I didn't see it, or I totally would have answered.
I needed you to answer, Max. Everybody thinks I'm a viral slut now.
There is no everybody. There's only your friends and your family who love you. Kate, please trust me. Come stand by me, okay? I can help you now. I know I can. This morning, I erased the web link to the video. It was written on the shower room mirror.
Are you serious? Thank you so much. The fact that you don't care about that video and would come up here to stop me means a lot.
Of course. Like I said this morning, I think Nathan is involved. I just need time to prove it. And I have a way with time.
You sound so persuasive, Max. If only.
Kate, I believe you. Will you believe me?
Please, you don't have to do this. Max, I'm in a nightmare and I can't wake up. Unless I put myself to sleep. Then everybody at Blackwell can post pics of my body. I'm horny on the internet forever. No wonder they call it a web. Nothing can ever get out. Like my video. I wish I could go back in time and erase everything.
Kate, this is our chance to beat the bullies. That's the only way we can win against them.
Can we really, Max? I don't believe in miracles anymore either.
Now I do. You're part of the reason why. If you come down with me, I can tell you more.
You're such a good person, Max. Even if you're full of crap. But I'll come with you. You're my friend.
Forever. Can we hug on it?
No! Nobody cares about me! Nobody!
Kate, I saw that card from your father. You can count on him. He clearly loves you without question.
Dad does care, even though I hurt him. He's the only one I know who believes in me. Sorry.
What are you talking about? You saved me from talking in class.
Now, I know today was difficult for everybody, but I'm so proud of the way Blackwell pulled together to save a young girl's life. Of course, you're quite a hero for getting Kate to come down, Max.
I didn't do much.
She's modest. Like a real hero.
Yeah, real hero.
As principal of Blackwell Academy, I take my duties seriously. I take the well-being of every student more seriously. What happened today should never happen in a hall of wisdom and knowledge. Mr. Madsen. As our head of security here, those roof doors should always be locked. That's just standard operating procedure. They were not, and that is indeed your responsibility. Mr. Jefferson, I know you can't be expected to know what your students are going through, but Kate has assisted you in class, so you should have known something was amiss. Mr. Prescott, since you are responsible for the Vortex Club parties, and since Miss Marsh did attend your last party, you'll have to answer some more questions. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the roof with Kate Marsh? Did Did she tell you her plan? Or anything at all? Please, tell us everything.
All I know is that Kate was at a party and Nathan dosed her. She got wasted and kissed some boys on a viral video without a clue.
I dosed her? Without a clue. Have you seen the video? Whatever. Kate was loaded and
planned
the field.
You told Kate you took her to the emergency room.
I said I was going to take her to the ER. She sobered up eventually.
Bullshit. Something happened to her and you know it. How about we talk about you waving a gun in the girls' bathroom?
That's total slander. I could sue you and this school so fast. I already have a personal lawyer.
Careful, Mr. Prescott. I have been told of this alleged gun incident, and I have to admit that the video in question was sent to me by multiple sources.
Including me.
And since Mr. Prescott does appear prominently in the video and was responsible for the party, I have no choice but to suspend him until further notice.
Whatever. See you in court.
Excuse me. I think Max and Nathan need a break before we grill them further. A friend and student just tried to kill herself. They don't need this forum right now.
Yes, I'm kind of devastated right now. I'd like to be with my family.
All right, Miss Caulfield, please sign here to confirm what you've told us. I'll continue this investigation from there.
My head is killing me, but I think I can use my power again.
Well, I think we know less now than when we started. We'll be assisting the police with further inquiries. I know this has been a stressful day. I wish I had the power to change it all for the better. So thank you for coming in.
I couldn't even believe it was happening. It was literally slow motion as I grabbed her hand. And then I could feel her grabbing mine.
Max, that was the greatest thing I've ever seen. Ever! You reached out, she reached out. Hugs, tears, applause. Like a superhero.
Not quite. Look at me. I'm a mess.
You're glowing. Seriously, a human halo. I'm pretty sure you earned your wings today.
I'm still worried about Kate. She did try to kill herself. All over a video.
Viral is the right word. Like a disease.
So you watched it?
Just one and a half times.
Warren, I don't mean to sound weird, but there's something ominous going on at Blackwell.
Today proves that.
And I'm working on proof that Kate Marsh is connected to Rachel Amber. Somehow. Along with Nathan and Mr. Madsen.
I'm not a big conspiracy guy, but I wouldn't doubt it. Nathan did scare me yesterday, and Madsen is a straight-up dickhead. So, what do you think is really happening?
What the hell is this? The weather confirms this weird day. I feel that chill.
Max, there was no eclipse scheduled today. I would know. I would.
I believe you, Warren. I'll believe anything this week.